Entonces, describir maíz es describir un mundo completo. El maíz tiene tantas formas, texturas y colores, incluso aromas que uno puede conocer y se puede ver en la gastronomía mexicana. Si ustedes pueden verlo en cualquier mercado, cualquier pueblo o villa pequeña. El maíz está en todos lados, no nos podemos escapar y tampoco ustedes.
Maize is all over the world. It's in many of our foods, it feeds our livestock, and it even provides energy as biofuels. But today, this crop faces an uncertain future in our fast-changing world. Why is maize vulnerable? And what can we do to protect it?
Mi nombre es Cristian Zavala. Me gusta hacer este trabajo porque mantenemos de alguna manera la diversidad de maíz que se encuentra en el mundo.
Located just outside of Mexico City, the International Maize and Wheat Improvement Center, or CIMET, protects the diversity of maize by storing seeds from more than 28,000 different native varieties, the largest collection in the world. There are tens of thousands of native maize varieties, but today, farmers grow many fewer varieties. So what happened to the diversity of maize?
La cultura del maíz en México ha existido siempre, desde que existen los libros de historia. México, de hecho, los mexicanos fuimos creados del maíz, según algunas culturas como la maya y la mexica.
About 10,000 years ago, indigenous farmers began cultivating a native grass called teosinte. Through many generations of selective breeding, teosinte evolved into the crop we know today as maize. Growing maize in diverse environments resulted in thousands of distinct native varieties, each well-suited to different conditions. But over the last century, crop breeders have used a handful of the most productive of these, the ones that grow the fastest and produce the most food per acre, to develop modern varieties that could be grown at large scales. Many scientists think that growing so few varieties of maize could come at a cost.
Actualmente estamos perdiendo muchas de las razas nativas que se han desarrollado durante los últimos 10,000 años. El peligro radica en que nosotros no sabemos qué estamos perdiendo.
A diversity of traits within a species is a powerful defense against changes in the environment. And each maize variety has different traits. One variety might be more resistant to a new disease, while another variety might grow better in drought conditions or extreme heat. So scientists want to preserve as many varieties of maize as possible in case these traits are needed. But how do you preserve thousands of native maize varieties? This is where seed banks come in. When the seed bank at CIMET receives new maize samples from farmers, Cristian and his team begin by checking the cobs for diseases.
Posteriormente se hacen pruebas de germinación en donde nos aseguramos de que la semilla esté viable para ser conservada a mediano y largo plazo.
Technicians take a random sample of kernels and put them in ideal growing conditions to see how many develop into healthy sprouts. Next, they take kernels from those cobs and sort them into envelopes that are vacuum sealed and stored in vaults, which are kept at low temperatures and constant humidity.
Y finalmente, se hace el desgrane de la semilla extra para guardar en un compuesto que nosotros llamamos bulk, que es básicamente mezclar toda la semilla extra y ponerlas disponibles para distribución a todo el mundo.
Storing and maintaining all these maize varieties is a lot of work, but it's really just the beginning. Once this diversity is preserved, how can it be used to improve maize agriculture in a changing world? To solve this problem, scientists turn to genetics.
My name is Sarah Hearne, and I try to identify characteristics, things that will help in the future develop varieties that are more tolerant to drought stress, to heat stress, to some of the pests and diseases that are starting to emerge as climates shift.
As growing conditions change, scientists want to identify the DNA sequences associated with traits that will help maize thrive.
So about 10 years ago, we took samples of every single one of those varieties. And we grew them out in very large greenhouses that we have here. And at the seedling stage, we chopped off the leaves, and we dried those leaves, and then from that we extract the DNA.
Sarah and her team compared the DNA of different varieties and identified locations in the genome where the DNA was different. Different versions of a segment of DNA are called alleles. These alleles often differ by just one nucleotide, one letter of DNA. For example, one allele might have an A, while an alternative allele has a T at the same position.
So this is where things get really exciting. We calculate what is called an allele frequency.
An allele frequency is a measure of how common a particular allele is in a given variety of maize.
So in a hot, dry environment, I have a very high frequency of a particular allele. And when I look at the cooler, wetter environments, I have different alleles which are present in high frequency.
Alleles found at higher frequencies in the hot, dry environments may be associated with traits that protect those plants from heat and drought, even if we don't know exactly how those alleles work yet.
The most important thing is there a difference in productivity when I have this allele or I don't have it?
To test this idea, Sarah and her colleagues selectively bred these promising alleles into modern varieties.
And we've got some lovely data which shows some really quite big boosts in productivity under things like drought stress when we start to incorporate this novel genetic variation.
Seed banks like the one at CIMMYT are a vital resource for global agriculture. And they wouldn't be possible without the indigenous farmers who have been cultivating native varieties of maize for thousands of years.
Creo que es un conocimiento que se ha transmitido de generación en generación. De ellos son los verdaderos guardianes y los verdaderos dueños de toda esta diversidad.
Scientists are finding new ways that the incredible diversity of maize, created and maintained by indigenous farmers and secure in seed banks, can ensure a future for maize that's both productive and resilient against emerging threats like climate change. If their work is successful, maize will keep powering humanity for a long time to come.